Hello YouTube, this is Prometheus 1979-9791. I'm here to do a first impressions video of a new knife that I got in the mail today. And no, I'm not doing an unboxing video. I was too excited to get it, so I already opened it. It's like Christmas. Mailman is like Santa Claus to me. This knife is pretty stinking cool so far, that I can tell at least. Really elegant looking. It is not an assisted opener, which is like one of the number one selling points for this knife to me. It is just really slick and smooth. And the thumb studs, I've never used thumb studs like this. Well, take that back, I have. I've handled a blur once. But I really like them because they're like little steps, you know, this little grounded out pattern. Or milled pattern, whatever you want to call it. So your thumb gets contact and you can provide pressure when you're pushing this out from the bottom of the thumb stud all the way to the top. So there's no real slipping or anything. In fact, let me just grab another knife to compare it to. Before this arrived, the thumb studs that I really favored and liked probably the best have to be the ones on this Microtech SOCOM. This is a manual action. And I don't know, there, you can see it there. See, it's got these graduated steps, kind of like an assize chain all the way up to the peak. And it provides contact with it really well. This knife, it just flips open like lightning. And it is butter smooth. And I really just love how they do that. I know it's not opening all the way now, but I'm just trying to show you how gentle you don't even have to do it hard. I mean, just the slightest flick, the thing just flies open. Awesome knife. I've had this thing for years. But back to the topic. This has got G10 handles, and they are pretty well smooth. I like it. I think it really looks elegant. You can see it kind of peaks up here and bevels off down the sides. And I thought, actually, after holding this and getting a hold of it, it kind of reminded me of the Spyderco Nalaka. And I don't have one of those, but just in reference, I've watched some videos on them and thought that looked a little similar to me. And it comes down to a peak here, a little point. The clip, I don't know about the clip. I've never carried one with a clip like this before, so I guess I'll get versed in how well that is. It's got this large bolt for the pivot screw, and this is, oh, in case I didn't mention it, this is the Kershaw Speedform II. The main thing that was the selling point of this, number one reason, was that it was made with ELMAX steel. So now I've got a new kind of steel that I haven't had experience with to get some use out of, and I'm looking forward to that. It's not a real beefy knife. It's actually very light. In fact, this is less than 4 ounces. I believe it is 3.5 ounces or 3.6 ounces. So it's pretty light, but it does feel pretty good in the hand. That's actually kind of impressive. And the blade is thicker than I had imagined that it would be. I figured with it coming with that type of steel that it would be like a sliver. So, because this knife was like $66 and it came with ELMAX steel. I think graduating up in price to the next lowest price ELMAX knife would be either the Spyderco Lion Spy or the Zero Tolerance 0560, I believe it is. And those are both about, they're $200+ knives, so for the price, it couldn't be beat. So, well, let's do a quick comparison in the blade thickness. It's an 1/8 inch thick, and this is comparing it to the Spyderco Endura 4 with the ZDP, and it looks to be about the same thickness, actually. So, it's not a sliver. It's actually a pretty well, you know, it's a pretty good sized thickness for a blade. I can get a full 4-finger grip on it. It's actually got this choiled out area here. It is rather comfortable in hand. Not the best for ergonomics necessarily, but it is pretty good. It's not uncomfortable. I haven't used it, and I'll find out more whether it's comfortable in the hand during use. So I could provide better insight to that later. This is marked Kai 3550, made in USA, and then it says ELMAX down here. So, yep, overall, it's a pretty nice looking knife. You can see it has three screws for the body that hold the backspacer in, and also holds the knife together. That's nice that they have three screws there, and then this pivot screw here. The more screws, the better, in my opinion. It holds the knife together more solidly. You can see the starter SMF has got four. It's got one, two, three, four, and then the pivot screw. And it is quite a bit bigger knife, actually. In fact, when we're talking about size, why don't we just do a little comparison to some of these other fine knives. There's the Tough. Tough kind of dwarfs it, too. Here's next to the Enduro 4. So it's probably around more like the Delica size. Microtech SOCOM. I don't know why I'm even showing you the size comparison. All these knives are pretty much the same size. But here's one comparison to the Benchmade, the Contigo. So, yep, pretty cool. I'm looking forward to carrying this too. I'm really trying to get versed in the performance of a lot of different types of steels. I'm actually getting a fairly good collection of them. I got the ELMAX, the S35EN, got 154CM, VG10, ZDP189, CPM3V, CPM M4, CPM 154. I can't even think of all the other ones, but I think those are mainly the all of the best steels that I'll have, or at least the most hyped steels. But I don't think it's just hype. Oh, an M390, should be getting that tomorrow back from Benchmade. And yeah, I'm super stoked. I can't believe it was only like $66. Chances are the heat treat might be a little different than like some custom makers do their ELMAX steel in. I hear that the ZTs with the ELMAX run their temper a little softer than they should be. I don't know, that could just be somebody's opinion. I'm not sure. But I will find out whether the edge retention is good on this or not myself. Because you can't always take somebody else's word for it. Sometimes you gotta get out and learn for yourself. But this knife did come out of the box hair shaving sharp. And I mean literally clean shaving sharp. I've never met a Kershaw that I didn't like, actually. I think they do rather make a good knife. I would probably say that they are probably at the same level as Benchmade. And I know you might be gasping. It depends on the knife. I mean, they definitely have cheaper models that don't compare, really. But, I mean, they're using premium steels. They got S30V, they got ELMAX. You know, 14C28N is a pretty good edge-holding steel. So, I think this company is really a diamond in the rough. And their knives are affordable. And they come with a lifetime warranty. And many of them are made in the USA if you're into supporting domestic-made products. So, there's something to consider. Looking at the stop pin, it's pretty thin little stop pin. This isn't a hard use knife. I'm sure you could use it pretty hard though. But one thing I really liked about it too is the liner and the liner lock. It's a really thick liner lock. I mean, let's see, where's that ZT at? Let's compare the thickness of the liners. You can see that they are very thick liners. They're almost as thick as the ZT. They're a little bit thinner. But one thing I also noticed is, see how the ZT has a cutout in the liner lock? This one doesn't have a cutout in it. I like that. Because I worry about those cutouts buckling. So, I mean, it's not likely that I would cause one to buckle, but it's a possibility. Stranger things have happened. So, Anyway, that's the new knife. That's the new addition to the family of knives. If you haven't noticed yet, I love knives. So, there you have it. That's my first impressions of the Kershaw Speedform II in ELMAX steel. Made in the USA, $66. That's a really good price for that. And like I said, we'll see how the steel performs. But anyway, I was talking about a little bit about the, you know, getting some hands-on use yourself and finding out, you know, when it comes to things and listening to other people's opinions, you know, some people are elitists and they like something because it's expensive and they have to reassure themselves that it's only good because it's expensive, and if something's cheap that it's not worth a darn. But, you know, like, I mean, any kind of critic can be wrong. I mean, that's the thing about critics and people who do reviews, is that is their opinion, you know. Like, my cousin, you know, he was saying that the Lord of the Rings sucked, you know, the movies sucked, and I had never seen them. And I didn't really care to, but then I found myself in a situation where someone was watching it, and I was there, and I was pretty thrilled with how good of a movie it was. You know, you can't just take somebody else's word for it. You gotta find out for yourself. I mean, one person's taste is not necessarily the same as another's. So anyway, thanks for watching. Sorry about all the long-winded talking, but hey, what did you come to see me for? Take it easy.